she only have a hole for menstruation and only for urination. I mean, they cut the whole thing and then they sew it. So this is Ethiopia in the Horn of Africa. Since we are working with all faith-based organizations, we can see that we cover the whole country. Girls are circumcised in Ethiopia varies from place to place. We have a number of testimonies where they have difficulties of pain during menstruation. And during labor, there is high probability to develop a fistula, meaning that she cannot control her urine. She could be exposed to a situation where you would be handicapped. When a mother gives birth, they go for a blessing. And they ask whether it's a boy or a girl. And then if it's a girl, they tell that, make sure that you don't circumcise. And if a father confessor says it, it says it. It's respected. And there are many girls who have been spared from the practice. How do we really take this as an advantage, religious leaders as influential figures? We kind of presented the facts. This is the health consequence. This is the psychological consequence. This is how prevalent it is. And then most of them, they were not aware of this. They came up with a theological reflection, and then they finally endorsed a declaration saying that in our text, we haven't found anything that supports this practice and submitted to the government. This is our commitment to end the practice as a national response. I believe that if we really continue with this momentum, and if there is strong support from the international community, especially supporting the local civil society organizations, including the faith-based organizations, I think change is evident.